Today, what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to cover some ways to replace some things on a screen. Okay. We're going to look at some of the different tools that are available. I think you're looking at my screen right now. If you're not, be sure and let me know. Okay. So we can so I can make sure I make that correction. All right. I don't want you to miss anything. So over here on the toolbar on the left-hand side, you know, that we've been working on. Let's see. One, two, three, four. Four little icons down. If you click and hold on this, a little window's gonna fly out. And it's going to show you three selection tools right there. Okay. So one of them is an object selection where you can go in and just tell it to click on one object and it'll try to go in and select just that object. I particularly chose this image today because it's very crowded and it's going to be a challenge for Photoshop to work with some of these. But we're going to see how it works out. I tested a couple of things down here, but I haven't tested a whole lot of other things. So we'll see what happens on this image. It's fun just to see what Photoshop can get up to, right? Okay, so the next one is called a quick selection tool. And that's a tool, it's kind of like a paintbrush, and which you can paint over different objects, and it will select the object that you paint over. And it's really good when you've got a large object that you're trying to select, and when it has a lot of distinction between, say, like these carts down here. So we've got some real difference between the runway and the cart right there, difference in color I'm talking about. So it would do a pretty good job at selecting these. We'll experiment with both of them. Now, the magic wand is a tool when you've got a huge expanse area like a sky that you want to select. The magic wand does a pretty good job because you can set the tolerance of it. In other words, how deep it'll go into the colors. The way the magic wand works is it looks, let's say we clicked right there with the magic wand. And what if the tolerance was set to 25? Let's just pull that number out of the air. And if it did that, it's going to look at 25 shades darker and 25 shades brighter as the areas that it wants to select. Okay. So the higher the tolerance, the more it's going to select in the sky. For instance, let's just start with the magic wand just for the fun of it. So I'm going to hit the magic wand. When it comes up, you'll notice it's right here. You probably see it moving. It's just got a it's like a little magic wand, okay? All right, so look up here. Remember we've talked about that on all the tools, every tool you select, there's a different set of properties related to that tool. Well, look right here. The tolerance on this tool right here is set to 7. I hope you can see that. It's pretty small on my screen, but anyway, the tolerance is set to 7. But if I click in there, let's make the tolerance 25. That was the number we talked about a minute ago, right? All right. And then let's click here in the sky and just see what happens. Okay. So I clicked in the sky and it actually did a pretty good job. But if you look down here, look at this on the side of this little gangway. Okay. That right there, it chose that because it's close to that color right there that I just chose. Okay. So you can see. And you can see up here in the sky, there's some little bitty dots blinking around, right? Okay, those are areas that are not selected. Okay, now it did a pretty good job of working its way around these ships over here, so that's good. And it actually did a pretty good job of doing those towers right there, so it does a fair job. Now, when you have something like this that you're working on, well, let's do something first. Let's do a Control D. I'm going to deselect, right? You know that command by now. Let's run the tolerance down to say 10. Okay, just a number and click and see what happens. Ah, now look what happened. Okay. I ran the tolerance down to 10, and now it didn't even get all the sky. Okay. So the tolerance will make a lot of difference in what's going to be selected. Okay. So when you're using the magic wand, if you're trying to select something, try deselecting and changing the tolerance up or down to see if you can get it to select the way that, that you want it to. Now, in some cases, let's do this. Let's do a command D and deselect, and let's run that tolerance back to 25, okay, like we had it a minute ago. All right, there's nope, that's 42, Steve. 25. There we go. All right, so let's do 25 again, and we'll click here in the sky like we did before. Now, notice this time, it didn't select this area on the side of the gangway. You see that? Okay. And the reason it did that is simply because I didn't click on the exact area that I clicked on last time. So if you look at this area right up here, okay, there's white clouds in there, as opposed to where I clicked over here, there were some blue in there. Okay. So it would have had different tolerances. It would have looked at different kinds of things. Okay. So just keep that in mind. It makes a lot of difference where you click. Okay. And so let's try this. Let's go Control D and let's go way over here on this side and click. Let's see what happens. All right. Now notice when I click on this side, guys. Look at this. It did not select this area here. Only what's selected is what's in those little marching ants, you know, the little lines, the circle here. Okay. It didn't select this area right here. Now, on any of the selection tools that we're going to work with, there are two, we'll call them subcommands that go along with these. Now, right now, we just have the magic wand. If I click on the sky right here, okay, it's going to change the selection. Do you see that? If I go up here and I click in this area again, okay, I'm not deselecting. I'm just clicking on different areas of the sky just to see what it would do. You see that? Now, let's say that we look at this and we go, you know, that's pretty good. It'd be nice if I could add this area right over here. So if I click on this area over here, problem with that is it changed to another selection, right? But if you press the shift key down, notice right below the magic wand, there is a plus mark. Okay. So with that plus, if I hold the shift key down and click in this area, that tells Photoshop that I want to add that area to the selection. Now that works with any of the selection tools you're going to be working with, okay? If you have a selection going on and you want to add to that selection, all you need to do is press down on this, hold the shift key down and select the additional area that you want to add to the selection. Okay. So that makes it really, really nice to be able to add to a selection. All right. Now, let's do something for fun. Let's go right up here and let's select the runway. Okay. Notice if I select something without holding down the plus, I mean, holding down the shift, it will just take the other selection away and it'll do this selection. Okay. Now, here's what I want you to see. Notice if I remember, if I press the shift key down, that's going to add, right? So, guess what? If I press the alternate key down, notice below the magic wand now, there's a minus sign. So anything, any color, if you will, that I click on with that minus and the magic wand, it's going to remove that color from the selection. For instance, this shadow over here beside the truck. If I click inside that shadow over there, okay, hopefully it's going to see, there it went, and it took it away, okay, and it left these areas, all right? So, anytime you're working with any of the selection tools, if you want to add, you're going to hold down the shift key. If you want to take away, you're going to hold down the alternate key. Now, let's look at something else. If I go Command D and deselect, let's go over here and get the lasso tool right here, the third one down. Okay. Lasso tool is just another selection tool, just another way to select something. So if I go right here and I left click and drag myself a little lasso around that particular part of the image, right? I'm guessing you can see that. If you can't, be sure and let me know. Okay, guys. So I've put a selection there, but let's say that I think I would like to add this part to the selection. Well, I've got this part already added with the lasso tool. Remember I told you, any selection tool, if we hold down the shift key, we can add. Now watch this. If I hold the shift key down, notice there's that plus, it appears. So if I click in around, you know, this selection right here, and then I click up here and I drag myself a little old circle around that and I end up back here. Look at there. It took that line away and it added all of that. Okay. Now, what if I wanted to take this away? Well, remember we press down the alternate key and we get that minus sign. Let's just say we don't want this part of the image selected. We draw a little circle around it and release it, right? So you've got a way by using the shift key on any of the selection tools, you can add with a shift and you can take away with the alternate. All right, keep that in mind as we work through some of this today. All right, Mandy. All right, so let's say that we've got this picture right here and this little these couple of little carts out here in the middle. Let's just say we want to get rid of them, and there's several ways that we can do that, but let's play with a couple of them just to see what happens. All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to come right down here where you see the little Band-Aid right there, right? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tools down. All right. If I left click and hold, we get all these tools out here, right? Okay. And any of these, to be honest, y'all, about any of these on here would work to do what we want to do to get rid of that cart. Okay. So a lot of times when we're working on images in Photoshop, there's distracting elements in the image and we want to get rid of them. And so what we're going to look at today is some ways to get rid of them. All right, let's try a couple. Let's go right here to this thing called the spot healing. No, I'm going to save that one. I got a better one I want to show you on there. Let's go down here to the patch tool. That'll be fun. So let's choose the patch tool. And notice when I choose the patch tool, the cursor, you get this arrow and you get this little thing that looks like a patch, right? Okay. Now, let's just left click and let's drag a little selection right around those two little carts. Okay, just like that. See the ant marching ants? Nothing fancy, nothing difficult about it. I just click and draw myself a circle around the object that I want to replace. Now, because the patch tool is selected, if I click in the center of this, inside that selection, okay? If I click inside that selection and drag it to another area, look at here. What it's doing, it's replacing what is in that selection with what is in this new selection out here, okay? So what I do is I usually try to find a part that kind of matches a little bit and then release. And then if we do a command D, look at that. We just got rid of those things, okay? I mean, it's pretty cool. Let's do it one more time just for the fun of it, okay? So control Z, right? We'll undo that. All right. So all we did was we went over here and got the patch tool, all right? And notice, y'all, a lot of these tools, if you just hover over them, it's going to give you a little video demonstration, you know, if you will. Now, this can also be turned off inside of your properties, but for right now, we'll leave them on. Okay. So we do this and we go over here and we left click and we make a little selection around that cart. Okay. And then we simply click inside the selection and drag somewhere else. Now you see the second selection that's kind of to the left of this, wherever that little circle is, that's where it's going to come. Look at this.
If I go up here to this ship, okay, look at that. It's going to copy that ship inside that selection. Well, that's not what we want, is it, right? We want it to look like it's the runway sitting up there. So maybe we'll go maybe right in there. Let's see what happens with that. We'll let go. All right. Now look at here. I got a little bit of a glare of another area, didn't I? Okay, so that didn't work very well. So I just click again and drag it somewhere else. And I notice this part of the runway is darker than this part up here. So I kind of want them to match a bit, don't I? Yeah, so I'm looking for a matching area and I drop it on there and look at that. That's a pretty good selection right there. All right. So we just got rid of those two carts right there. Maybe we want to get rid of these little pieces out here. See the little orange cones that are behind the airplane there? Well, remember I told you that if we held down the shift key, we can add to a selection, right? Okay. So there's one. I'm going to hold the shift key down. And I'm going to select the other one. All I'm doing is left clicking and dragging a little circle, right? Okay. I'm going to go here. So there we go. We got three little cones selected. All right. And I'm going to click in the center of, in the middle, inside the selection of one of them. It doesn't matter which one. Okay. And I'm going to click and drag it to the side or somewhere else. I'm going to try to make the runway area, whatever is appearing in that selection, make it look kind of like it was there, right? Okay. So I'll go with that. I'm gonna click off of there. Yes. Now that did a pretty good job. But if you look really, really closely, guys, right here, okay, let's see if I can do something here. Let's go. Let's see what happens. Nope, that's not gonna work. There is a Okay, it's not going to let me do that command anymore. They keep changing things in Photoshop. Notice that it took part of the shadow away right there. You see that? And so that's one of the things you got to watch when you're using these different tools is that if you're going to do a replacement, is the replacement going to look natural? Okay, you don't, because if you looked at this right now, and look at that shadow real close, you'd see, okay, I got shadow, shadow, shadow. Empty space, and then I got shadow again, right? So you'd either have to go in there and paint that shadow in there, or you know what we could do? We could use another tool. Let's do that. Let's go over here, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 tools down, and there's a tool that looks like a stamp. Okay, if I left click and hold on it, it shows me that I can do patterns, or I can do something called a clone stamp. Now this is really interesting because with the clone stamp I can actually select any area of the picture and then clone that area to another area of the picture. All right, let's see how this works. So you're going to get the clone stamp. And I want to clone this shadow right there. Okay. I want to clone it inside that little opening right there. Right. Now, right now, the brush, if you will, that circle is a little large. Okay. Now, remember, we talked about, I think it was the first week we talked about that if you look at the bracket keys, they're the keys just to the right of the letter P. Okay. P as in Paul. The left bracket key will make the brush smaller, and the right bracket key will make the brush larger. Okay, so that's just a quick way to enlarge or decrease the size of the brush as you need it. Okay, now the way this thing works, and I'm going to run this up just a little larger just so you can see it. In fact, hold on, guys, I'm going to go over here and get the magnifying glass. And I want to magnify this area right here. Okay. So I want you to really be able to see that. Okay. So, what we're wanting to do is we're wanting to make this shadow right here. Right. Okay. All right. So, let's go back over here again and let's get the magic wand, get the stamp brush back. Now, I'm going to use the bracket key and make it a little smaller. Now, what I decided, since this one has two shadows falling under it because of the double wing right there, I'm going to go in here and copy this shadow. Okay. Now, the way the stamp tool works or the clone tool is you click on something to show Photoshop what you want to copy. Okay. And then you go and paint that over. Now, let's just demo it a couple times, okay? Now, to tell Photoshop what I want to copy, I hold down the alternate key. Now, watch the brush when I hold down the alternate key, okay? If I hold the brush down, notice it becomes what looks like a target when I hold the brush, when I hold the alternate key down, okay? So if I go right here and I put that target over there and I left click one time and then I release, notice now right in the middle of that brush, there's this little floating black line. Do you see that? Okay. So if I go right here and connect now, notice right be, I don't know if you can see it or not, but directly behind that brush, there's a little bitty plus mark. All right. And wherever that plus goes, it's going to copy that particular area. Look at that. We just filled it in. Now that put another little blank right there. So let's do this. Let's run this up a little bit. Let's hold the alternate key down. Let's click that. And let's see if we can't get that to go back too. There we go. Look at that. So if we zoom back out now, look at here. That shadow's back to normal now. All right. So the clone tool just allows you to copy one part of the picture and paste it to another part of the picture, basically. Okay, let's try it again. Let's go up here. Let's see. Let me do the zoom tool real quick and let's zoom in on this little thing out here. Okay, right there. It's real grainy, but that's okay. All right, so I'm going to get the clone tool back, okay? Or the stamp tool, whatever you want to call it. I want to copy this over to here. Okay. All right. Let's just see if we can do that. All right. So here's what I want you to notice. Notice that that little spot in the middle here, you can see it real good there. That yellow spot that's moving around, that's how big the area is that you're going to copy. Even though the brush is very, very big. Okay. But watch this. If I increase the size of my brush, notice that yellow area inside the center grows larger. Do you see that happening? I mean, that's really big there. We bring it on down. So you can control the area of the brush. So let's say we want to copy this whole thing over here. Okay, that's pretty easy. Let's go down here. Let's hold the alternate key down. Okay. And we're just, well, I didn't want to zoom out like that. Hold on a minute. Let's see what's going on here. All right. Let's see if I can get us zoomed back in. Here we go. I'm gonna hold the alternate key down. Notice it becomes a target, right? I'm gonna click right there. Okay. So now I have that red area at the end ready to copy. So if I come right here now, because I'm going to where I want to put it, right? So I want to put it down here and move it away from that part. So if I go here and I click, notice that little bitty plus mark now. It's moving right behind that piece right there. And look at that. I now have two of those runway signs. Okay. I'll zoom back out. Look at that. Looks just, I mean, unless you zoom in like 500% like I was, you really can't tell it, right? So maybe now that we've moved that one there, maybe we want to get rid of that one, right? Okay, let's go back to that patch tool that we used a minute ago, right? And let's just draw ourselves a little old circle right there, okay? And if we drag it down here, y'all, notice what's going into that top selection there. It's putting runway in there, right? We don't want that. We want grass to be in there. So we have to find a spot that looks natural. Look at there, right there. If I put it right there, that's pretty close to being natural. It's not perfect, but it's okay for right now. So if I do that, now I have moved that. Now, if I was really doing this for real, okay, I'd pay a lot more attention like that part right there just to get rid of it. So I wanted you to see that particular area right there. Now, I'm going to show you another replacement tool that we've got here. And I'm just going to undo what we just did right there because we don't need that. All right, I'm going to go over here and duplicate the background. Remember, Command J. And it duplicates the background, and we're in really good shape there, ready to go. All right, now here's what I want to do. I'm going to turn off the background because I want you to really pay attention to what's happening here. So I'm turning off the background, just leaving that regular layer on there. Okay. Now, I want to get rid of this bunch of stuff right here. All right. But I don't want to have to grab a patch tool, and drag it up here to this area, something like that. I want to do it a little bit quicker. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go up here. I'm going to get the lasso tool. All right. And I'm just simply going to drag myself a selection. I want to get the shadow too. That may be too big, but we're going to try it. And we'll go up here. So now this whole area right here, shadow and all, is selected, right? Okay. Here's what I want you to see. If I go up here to the edit menu at the top of the page, and if I come down about a third of the way, there is a tool here, or a command, if you will, that's called Content Aware Fill. Okay. Now, what Content Aware Fill does is it will look at your selection and then it will look at the rest of the picture and it will try to match what's in the rest of the picture and put it in that selection area. I know, it's magic. Now, let's see what happens. I'm going to click on Content Aware Fill. Now, it's going to turn green in just a minute. Now, look right here. This green area is the area that it's going to select from, okay? And look at the preview over here. Look what it has done, okay? It's looking at all this green area right here and saying, maybe Steve wants me to put stuff that looks like a runway into this area right here. And look at there, it did it. All right, I'll come down here to the bottom right and I'll click OK. And when I do, it'll take just a moment, but it has taken that bunch of trucks and stuff like that away. But I know what you're saying. You're looking at it kind of closely and you're going, yeah, but it doesn't look perfect. You're right, it doesn't. Because if you look at these little shadows here, that doesn't work. There's a line right along here. That doesn't work too good. But overall, it did a pretty good job. Now, we could easily go in here and clean this up. For instance, maybe we go right here. We'll select that little area right there. Okay. And let's go up here to edit again. Let's choose the content aware. Oh, look, there's no content aware fill. Well, there is, but it's grayed out. Here's why. Look over here. Notice when it does a content aware fill, it creates a new layer with that fill on it. Watch this. If I turn this little eyeball off, look at there. That's before we did it, and that's after. So what we have to do is go back to the original layer here, okay? And now we should be able to go up here to edit, okay? And come down, and there's Content Aware Fill. Let's click it again and see what happens. Let's see if it does a good, better job. And it goes, okay, I'm going to look at this area out in here and try to clean that up for you. Now, let me show you what's fixing to happen. I'm going to go ahead and do it so you'll see it. All right. It did not do a very good job because this layer is above it. If I turn this layer off, it brings the truck back, but it does this. So here's the deal with content aware fill. All right, let's just start over here, okay? So I'm going to drag this one down to the trash can. I'm going to drag this one to the trash can, and I'm just going to go here, okay? Let me deselect. Now, what I'm going to do, what I have learned over time in working with content aware fill or generative fill or any of these, is if you'll take small bites of the image that you're trying to redo, it works a lot better than if you try to bite the whole chunk. Like I was trying to bite this whole thing off in one big piece, okay? So it works better if I do it kind of small. Let's just see what happens. So if I just circle just this little area right up here, okay, let's try it. Let's go up here to edit. Let's come back down to content aware fill. It's going to look around and say, okay, I'll try to fill it with this green area here. And you click okay. Let's see how well it does. Give it just a second while it's thinking. trying to figure out what it wants to do. Now, look here. It actually did a much better job, didn't it? Okay. We've got these lines that are pretty normal in the runway, but we can get, see, there's some over here, but we could get rid of those real easy. All right. So let's do this now. Since we know that if we do another content-aware fill, that this is going to cover it up, let's learn a new shortcut. Let's hold down the Shift and the Alternate and the Command all at one time. Shift, Alternate, Command. All right. And then touch the letter E. Now, look what just happened over here on the layers. It took all these layers from below and combined them into one big layer. All right. That's really helpful because now we can go in here and we can select another part. Let's see if this one right here is small enough for it to think about. Okay. Let's go there. Let's go to Edit. Let's go to Content Aware Fill. And let's just wait for a second and see what happens. It's looking at the picture now and trying to decide, okay, where's the best way? Oh, it actually did a pretty fair job. Let's click OK again. Okay, give it just a second to think about it. It's going to create a new layer with the changes on it. And look at this, y'all. It's actually pretty good, but we still got that big old shadow down there, don't we? All right. Okay. Well, let's do it. Let's do another thing. Let's do Command, Alternate, Shift, and E again. Okay. Make us another layer. All right. And let's go down here and just select this little old shadow down here that's left over. Remember, I said we're just trying to get these things taken care of piece by piece by piece. All right. So we did that. And then let's go back up here again. Let's go to Fill. Let's go to Content Aware Fill. And let's give it a second to think about it. And we'll just say okay and let it go ahead and do its thing. And let's see how well it does. Okay. All right, it's coming. There we go. Okay. Now it did a pretty fair job, although we did get some straight lines right there. If you look at it real close, you can see them. And these lines right here, and maybe those lines right up there don't need to be there. Well, maybe in that case, we could get the patch tool that we used earlier, right? And maybe go right here. Whoops, I didn't want that. I missed it. Maybe go right here and select this little area, maybe. And okay, I know. Oh, okay. It's telling me that I don't have anything to select from right here. Let's go here and let's flatten this image out entirely. Okay. I'll explain flattening on another day. It's no big deal. Okay. Oops, that didn't need to be right there. I had a selection there. Control D. All right, here we go. Let's duplicate the background. All right, here we go. We got the patch tool. Let's make our little selection here. And let's drag it down to another area, something that kind of matches, that area right there. And then we'll put that right there. Look at there. That's pretty good. Let's kind of get rid of this area right here. That's kind of bugging me a little bit. All right, let's do that. We'll move it forward. There we go. Or maybe it needs to be more of this color. I don't know. I'm just looking at the destination where it's going to go. And I look at that, I go, that's pretty good. Now it's not perfect. You see some cloudiness in here and stuff like that. We'd have to do some cleaning up, okay? But nothing is perfect inside Photoshop, right? We have to do it little by little. Now, let's go up here to history and let's go all the way back to where we started because I want you to see another little trick in here. So I'm going to go to the background here and I'm going to duplicate, Control J, okay? And I think I'll turn the background off and just be on this one layer, right? Remember the background, we duplicate it so that we're working non-destructively, right? All right, let's try something. Let's go over here and let's get the lasso tool, all right? And I want to select this area right up here, okay? I'm gonna make it hard on it, all right? So I've got all this area in here, and I've got all this area here. And I got this airplane sticking up, the tail sticking up into that area right there, right? There's a lot of changes there, but I want you to see something. This next selection area or tool, we come way down here to the bottom, and we've got this tool down here called Generative Fill, okay? This is where AI jumps in on Photoshop. So if I hit generative fill, at first it's got a blank here. It says, well, what do you want to fill that selection with? Okay, we could tell it anything. We could tell it a boat or whatever, you know. But let's just do this. Let's not put anything in the circle there. Let's just tell it to generate. Let's just see what happens. So I'm going to hit generate. Notice up here at the top, it tells me it's generating some options for me. And over here on the right-hand side, above the layers, you notice there's three boxes up there, and there's three little blue things circling around up there. It's thinking about what to do. But look at this, y'all. All of that is gone, okay? And it's clean. And look at this. It even replaced those walls that were behind the tail of that airplane. Now, it gave us three options. Let's see what they are. That's the first option. If I click here, there's the next option. Did you see how that changed right there? Let me go back to the first one. Watch this area right up here, okay? If I go here, there's one area. Okay, let's try another option. Oh, I kind of like that one right there. That looks pretty good. Let's see the third one. We'll click the third one. Oh, the third one is great. Look at that. The wall is all in line. Everything's okay and clean down here. The runway matches the whole bit. Okay. So if I turn that layer off, there it is before. Notice how the tail was up on this area right here and covering that part of the sign. If I turn that back on, look at that. Now, y'all, that's pretty cool. Okay. Now, do I still use the magic wand and the patch tool and stuff like that? I sure do. I use them all. Okay. Generative fill is just another tool. Let's just see how far this thing can go. Let's try something. Let's flatten the image. Flatten means you're going to take all these layers and you're going to mash them down into one unit. Okay. So here I'm going to do this. I'm going to go right here and I'm going to come all the way down to flatten image. It sounds like Siri's trying to butt in on us. Don't worry about it. Okay, so I flattened it out. Now I'm going to duplicate it. Control J. Okay, there we go. All right, now let's just see what happens here. I have not tried this. So let's select this whole area right here, shadow and all. Okay, let's make this really tough on Photoshop. Let's see if it can do it. So we're going to do that. We're going to come down here to this little window, generative fill. Okay, and hit generate. All right. Now, the bigger the selection that you're trying to get AI to look at, the longer it takes. But notice it's plugging along pretty good. Okay. So we got that window up there saying, hey, I'm working on this. Hang in there. And then it's showing, and look at this, y'all. Look at this. It carried the lines on across, the shadows gone. Let's see what the other choices are. Here's another choice. Look at that. That one's not as good. I don't care about all this down here. Let's see what the other one looks like. That's pretty good right there too. Okay, but I think I like the first one the best because this is kind of distracting to me. I think I kind of like that. So we turn it on and we turn it off. Now, y'all, that's almost scary right there, isn't it? Okay. So I just wanted you to see what that there's lots of different ways that we can replace things in photos. Now I want to show you a couple other things here. I think it's this. Nope, that's not the one I wanted. Hold on. Here we go. Now, this image here, I don't know how well you can see these, gang. If you look on here, the sensor on my camera, I was shooting with an old film camera in this one, right? It was an old Nikon D3. Okay. And the sensor had gotten dirty. Okay. Because, you know, I'm out on the ocean, sensor got dirty, and I just didn't take the time to clean the sensor. And so I got all these little spots. You see them on there? Okay. It's like having a dirty lens, right? So there's a lot of good ways to get rid of things like this. Okay. Let's do this. Let's duplicate the background, Command J. Okay. And I'm going to come over here and I'm going to left click and hold on the, in this case, it'd be the patch tool because that's the one we were just using. But this first one right here says spot healing brush. All right. Gosh, y'all, this thing is absolutely magic right here. If you've got, if you did a portrait of somebody and they had some little bumps or something on their face you wanted to get rid of, this is the tool to do it with. All right. So I want to get rid of all these little spots in the sky. So I get the healing brush, okay, the spot healing brush, because there's two of them. I'll show you another one in a minute. And I'm just going to go in here and paint little dots. You'll see the little black dot that appears in there. Okay, look at that. And slowly but surely, I'm getting rid of all that sensor dirt that was on the sensor of that camera. Okay, you see it going away? Look at that, y'all. Here's one over here. All right, here, let's take out one that's more obvious. See this cloud down here? Watch this. Cloud's gone. Okay. So this is a great way to clean up an image. Now, when you're cleaning, you don't have to just do one at a time like this. Okay. Here's what we can do. We can go in here and I can just kind of move the cursor around to different places where I see those little dots. Here's some way over here. Okay. I'm just kind of looking to see where I see spots. Here's some right here, okay? And when I let go, it's gonna look at that whole area right there. Now it takes a little bit longer because I gave it a lot to think about right there, okay? But look at that. It almost took it all away, but it kind of goofed up right there a little bit. We can get rid of that just by doing this, okay? And so what it's gonna do is just look at the sky and say, okay, how do I make that match? Okay, so using the spot healing brush is really, really handy. Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to delete that layer, create another layer, Command J. Okay. I'm going to go over here because under the spot healing brush, all right, there's a new one called Remove Tool. And then there's one down here called Healing Brush Tool. You see that one? All right, so if I do the healing brush tool, y'all, works like the clone stamp. Remember where you choose a location for it to copy from? So let's do this. Let's go right in this area. That looks pretty clean right there. I'm going to hold the alternate key down. Notice there's that target again that we saw a minute ago. I'm going to click here. Now what it's going to do as I go through here and remove these brushes, do you see that little plus that's about the 2 o'clock mark off the side of that circle? Wherever that plus goes, that's where it's choosing to clone from or to heal from. Okay, you see that happening? Okay, so if you've got a sky that's got a lot of variation in it, gosh, y'all, I would use this tool right here because it's looking at different areas of the sky and copying them from one area over to another area and really helping clean this image up. Look at that. No more sensor dust. Okay. So that's really, really helpful right there. Now, we could even get rid of the sun if we wanted to. Watch this. But it's going to fill it in with whatever's in that area. Look at that. It's kind of a mess, isn't it? Yeah, we don't want that. It's too many rays sticking out from the sun right there. But you can see how that really cleaned that up really, really well. All right. Okay, so I'm going to go back here. I've got one more example I want to give you. And then we're just about out of time. We got about 15 minutes, so that'd be just right. All right, so got this picture of this little walkway going down through here. Did my best to try to get the picture without a person in it, but it didn't work. So there's three things in this, well, four really, that distract me quite a bit in this picture. All right. So when I look at this picture, the guy is kind of a distraction. I didn't want a picture of a guy. Okay. I wanted a picture of this walkway. All right. And the trash can right here, y'all. The trash can's a pain. Okay. In the past, we would have gone in there with a clone stamp and did it little by little by little. But now we got some really great tools. You've seen some of them. There's another distracting thing over here on the left. I think that's a gutter or something like that that's over there. And that's kind of distracting because the rest of it's nice and clean and white all the way down. So we need to get rid of that. And then this red side of this building over here. Okay, that bugs the stew out of me. What happened is the sky was blown out over there. It was just so bright in that area. There's not really a lot of data in there for Photoshop to fool with on this, right? Okay, because you can see even the sky's blown out. All right, let's try to get rid of a little bit of this. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go over here to our selection tools. Okay, now we could try patch and any of these kind of things like that. But I want to suggest that we let AI take care of all of this for us at one time. Let's see if this works. I have no idea. I know we want this one right here. So let's see, let's duplicate our background first, okay, just for the fun of it. All right, I'm gonna turn the background off. There we go. Now it's only looking at that. So I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna make a little circle right around whatever that black thing is. It's a gutter or something like that. Okay. Now, remember I told you we hold a shift key down to add to a selection, right? Okay. Well, let's go right here and let's do ourselves a little circle right around that feller. Okay. So now we got that and that. Let's go over here. Now, this is going to be a huge challenge for Photoshop. If it does all this, that's going to be incredible. All right. So now we got the trash can selected. Now we need to get rid of that building over there. Okay. So let's go in here and let's just make ourselves a little old selection right around that red square right there. Okay. Kind of like that. Okay. All right. So I'm going to let go of my shift key now. Right. And so now I've got one, two, three, four things selected. All right. Those are things I want to get rid of. I'm not going to do anything but come right down here to the bottom. And I'm going to click on generative fill. All right. Now, when it comes up, it's going to ask me, what would you like to fill these holes with? I'm saying nothing, just fix it. So I'm going to hit generate. It's going to take just a moment. Okay. It's thinking about it. It's working up here at the top. Okay. You see it working. You got those three areas right over here are three choices, if you will, that we can add to and fix it. Now remember, the more things you have selected, the longer it takes to fix them. But look at this picture, y'all. Look at this. The gutter's gone. The guy's gone. It even filled the sidewalk in. The trash can is gone. It even built the bush back in right there. Remember here, let's turn it off. Look at that. That trash can was covering that bush. But the generative AI looked at it and said, well, there's bushes here and bushes here. It probably is a bush back there, too. Look at that, y'all. It just built it back. Look at this up here where the building was. Look at that. I mean, is that magic or what? Okay. All right. So we look at that. But it gave us three choices. Let's see what the other ones are. Okay. There's that one. Let's go from one to the other. All right. There's that one. I don't think I like the second one because look at this. See where the bush is right there, y'all? Look what happens when we do the second one. It's not lined up as well, is it? No, so we don't want the second one. So let's try the third one. Oh, the third one's not bad. Okay, the building's gone, the trash can's gone, the bush is in there, the sidewalks are lined up nice. The sidewalk, yeah, it kind of jots. I don't know, maybe it doesn't. Hold on. Yeah, see on the third one? The sidewalk right here, the line in the sidewalk kind of goes out. I know I'm being really picky here, okay? The line goes out, but look here on the first one. Look at that. That line stays straight, right? And it filled the bushes in too. So I kind of like that one. So that's the one I would use right there. So as you can see, the generative fill, it has revolutionized how we can select things in an image and how we can clean those images up. All right. Now, if your generative fill is not showing up, just come up here to the window area, and you can turn it on. Remember, the ones of these that are clicked, they're the ones that are showing. Okay. And so you can turn them on down there. Or you can go, I think they put it, let's see, they keep moving it on me, but I want to make sure I'm telling you the right place because I can't remember exactly. I bet it's under select. No, I can't find it right at the moment. Okay, it's under one of these little things right here. So if it turns up that yours doesn't show up, just go right here and just tell it to do it. And I'm just trying to I think it comes up automatically. I know it always has on mine. So if I click those three dots, I can pin it to a position, I can do more properties, and I can give feedback to Photoshop on this. But anyway, it should appear right down there at the bottom of the screen. If it doesn't, let me know, and I'll do a little bit more research on it to try to find it for you, and so we can look at that together a little bit more. Any questions at this point that over what we've covered so far. So do you like these tools? Yes, no, thumbs up, maybe, no, not at all. Okay, all right, Austin likes them. Good deal. I'm glad to see that. All right. So I would encourage you this week for homework, okay? Just for practice, get on Photoshop, choose some photos that have some distracting elements in it, and go over here to the left-hand side and try the lasso tool and the generative fill. And maybe go here to the Band-Aid and try some of these, the patch tool particularly. Okay, try that. Try the spot healing brush on some small spots, that you're trying to clean up, like I did on the sensor dust just a minute ago. Okay, try out these different tools. There's even a red eye tool here that just does fantastic. Okay, all you do is you click the brush, and it'll give you a little bit of brush, and you put it right over the pupil. Boom, it takes care of the red eye. It's done. It uses AI also. So I'd encourage you to check out those little areas right there. Try it. If you have problems during the week when you're working on these different pieces, hold on, cancel that. Pieces. And I'm going to show you one other thing, and I'm not going to tell you a lot about what it's doing, but I'm going to just show you something, and then you can go in there and look at it later. All right, let's see. Let's try this. This might be fun. I hadn't tried this before. So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to take an elliptical. All right, and I think I'll go right over here and draw myself a circle. All right, now I'm going to come down here to generative fill. All right, I'm going to click that and I'm going to say full moon. Let's see what it does. So what I'm doing is I made a selection of what I would like it to put into the picture. And I said, that's where I want it to be. Okay. And then I told it what I wanted there to be there. Okay. And look at this. It might do a good job. We'll see. That's pretty good right there. That's almost in perspective. Okay. Now, here's what's cool about this. Because it's on a layer by itself, if that's too bright, I could actually go in there and drop the opacity, couldn't I? Okay, maybe make it where it's not quite so bright. All right, let's try one other just for the fun of it. I like playing with this thing, it's just cool. Let's go right down here. Let's get the lasso tool and let's go right here. All right, now I made a selection, kind of the sim. I wanted to put a sailboat in there. So I kind of made it what outline of a sailboat might be look like. I'm gonna hit generative fill. I'm gonna put a sailboat. Okay. And then I hit enter or generate. It'll take just a moment. You see it working up here. It's trying to figure out exactly, what's going on. And it's looking on the internet and on stock images and stuff like that. Look at this. There's the sails of a sailboat. Let's see what the other one looks like. Okay. So what I've done here is because it's so dark down here. Yeah. What it's doing, y'all, it's actually doing a good job. You can't see it, but I can see the water's dark and the bottom of the ship is dark. Okay, but look at this. You can see the mast because it's got contrast right there. But look at that, y'all. It created a sailboat down there, although we can't see it very well right now. All right, here, let's do this. Let's go here. We'll do one more. And let's say here, let's just make it simple. Let's say right here. Okay. Yeah, I just drew a shape. Okay. Let's go generative fill. And let's say an old airplane. All right. Let's just see what happens. I have no idea. I've not tried this. Anyway, generative fill is a lot of fun to play with. The results are going to, your mileage may vary, as they say on the car commercials. Okay, but sometimes it'll actually do a pretty good job. Oh, that's interesting. But look at this guy's head. He looks sort of like an alien. So that's not going to work. That's not an old airplane. Oh, now that's not bad right there. That kind of fits in the picture, doesn't it? Right? And then here's one other. Oh, they let that one bring the wing out. Okay. So you can see that it will depend on the picture. Okay. And what you're trying to tell it to do. Now that one's not too terrible bad right there. Okay. So you can see with generative fill, you can also create an empty space. And then you can tell it what you want to put in that space. Try it this week and see how that works for you. All right. Okay. Well, guys, if there's no other questions, we'll call that a day. And go out and play with generative fill, play with the patch tools, play with the different healing brushes, and just see what kind of things you can come up with. All right. And remember, I'm always here. You can reach me on Teams or you can reach me on email. I think I've given you my email before, but just in case, src@uk.edu. There you go. There's my email address. And feel free to reach out to me at any time, either email or on Teams to chat. And I'll get back with you really, really quickly. All right. Have a great day, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.